Good evening, I'm Shoghi Mohammed, and this is the 7 o'clock news. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa issued an order reinstating the citizenship of 551 convicts whose nationality had been revoked as per court rulings. The royal order is in line with the provisions of Article 24 Biz of Law 58 of 2006 with respect to the protection of the community against terrorist acts, stipulating that rulings related to citizenship withdrawal will not be effective unless they are approved by His Majesty the King. His Majesty the King had already given directives to the competent authorities to evaluate the situation of convicts whose citizenship is revoked before the final implementation of the court judgment. The study and evaluation of the situation of convicts should be based on criteria pertaining to the seriousness, impact, and consequences of the crimes, as well as on the danger the convict may pose on national security. His Majesty requested the Interior Minister to study the citizenship revocation rulings and to prepare a list of reinstatement beneficiaries. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa issued Edicts 5 and 6 of 2019. Edict 5 renamed the National Committee to Combat Non-Contagious Chronic Diseases to become the National Committee to Combat Non-Communicable Chronic Diseases. Edict 6 stipulated the restructuring of the National Committee to Combat Non-Communicable Chronic Diseases. Edict 6, Article 1 stipulated the reconstructuring of the National Committee to Combat Non-Communicable Chronic Diseases, presided over by the Minister of Health, with the following as members: the Ministry of Health's Assistant Undersecretary for Public Health, Director of Public Health Directorate, Director of Health Promotion, Representative of BDF Medical Services, Representative of King Hamad University Hospital, Representative of the Ministry of Industry, Commerce and Tourism, Representative of the Ministry of Works, Municipalities Affairs and Urban Planning, Representative of the Ministry of Education, Representative of the Ministry of Information Affairs, Representative of the Supreme Council for Health, Representative of Bahrain Chamber of Commerce and Industry, Representative of Mohammed bin Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa Specialist Cardiology Center, Representative of the Ministry of Youth and Sports, Representative of Bahrain Diabetic Society, Representative of Anti-Smoking Society, and Representative of the Anti-Cancer Society. The duration of their membership will be 3 years, effective from the date of implementation of this edict, and renewable for similar periods. The ministers have been tasked, each according to the relevant domain, to implement this edict, effective from the day following the date of its publication in the Official Gazette. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received today at the Dhulaibiya Palace a number of royal family members and officials, where His Royal Highness discussed with them local and regional affairs. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister affirmed the kingdom is a state of institutions and law, and it is imperative to respect its laws and abide by its provisions. He noted the role of Bahraini citizens in serving their country and society, and highlighted the cohesion of the Bahraini people under the leadership of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa. His Royal Highness affirmed that Bahrain has taken rapid steps in various development fields by adopting programs and strategies to ensure the sustainability of this development in accordance with international standards and commensurate with the requirements of present and future needs. The Prime Minister noted that Bahraini citizens had a vital role in the development of Bahrain and proved to be the basis for the country's efforts towards development and progress. His Royal Highness affirmed the government's keenness to ensure the development projects meet the aspirations and needs of citizens in various cities and villages and contribute to alleviating burdens of citizens and providing them with decent living conditions at all levels. His Royal Highness stressed the importance of community partnership in achieving development, noting that the people of Bahrain have a responsibility towards the country. His Royal Highness also stressed the importance of investing in the promising opportunities of the national economy to continue pushing the development process, activate the economic movement, and provide more job opportunities for the citizens. His Royal Highness, the Prime Minister, highlighted the need to preserve the values of unity and community cohesion. His Royal Highness also affirmed that the Arab nation is facing many challenges that threaten its security and stability and the right of its people to development, stressing the importance of vigilance and communication to protect regional countries and preserve their gains. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received the Editor-in-Chief of Gulf News, Anwar Abdurrahman, and journalist Dr. Ibrahim Sheikh, who expressed thanks and appreciation to His Royal Highness for his support to journalistic work in the kingdom to convey the noble message of journalism, serve the country, and defend its causes. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister hailed the role of national journalism as a platform for society and a defense line that proved its effectiveness in various circumstances, stressing the necessity for responsible journalism. His Royal Highness commended the role of Gulf News in local and Gulf journalism, wishing the newspaper's staff success in serving the country and its people. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa today welcomed this year's recipients of the Crown Prince's International Scholarship Program at Rufaa Palace. During the meeting, His Royal Highness affirmed that investing in Bahrain's youth is an important element of the Kingdom's efforts to help drive sustainable development as part of Bahrain's Comprehensive Development March led by His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince highlighted the significant achievements of the CPISP, stressing that the program, which is now in its 20th edition, continues to deliver educational opportunities at world-class academic institutions for remarkable Bahraini students. His Royal Highness concluded by expressing his appreciation for all who continue to support the program and extended his congratulations to the students for meeting its rigorous standards. The recipients of the 2019 CPISP scholarships are as follows: Abdullah Musa Ali, the International School of Shuwaifat, Ali Farouk Al-Akri, St. Christopher's School, Yasmin Nabil Nuruddin, Bin Khaldun International School, Zain Muhammad Zainal, Abdurrahman Kano International School, Ahmed Ibrahim Ali, Sheikh Abdul Aziz Bin Muhammad Al-Khalifa Boys Secondary School, Ahmed Hussein Salman Al-Naim Secondary School, Hassan Tariq Al-Gassab, Sheikh Abdul Aziz Bin Muhammad Al-Khalifa Boys Secondary School, Fatma Muhammad Abdullah Sar Secondary Girls School, لين مازن النصور المعرفة Secondary Girls School, سارة سعيد محمد محرك Secondary Girls School. Recipients were selected from among 420 Bahraini participants following a comprehensive process that took into account their grade point average, IELTS score, SAT score, leadership training and a critical thinking course, which were organized by the CPISP as part of the candidacy training. The CPISP offers scholarship recipients the opportunity to choose their own fields of study at any university they gain acceptance to. The program has awarded a total of 187 university scholarships since its establishment in 1999 by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince. His Majesty the King's Representative for Charity Work and Youth Affairs and Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, attended a conference by the Bahrain Center for Strategic, International and Energy Studies in which political and intellectual figures from Bahrain and other Arab countries have participated. The conference featured a reading from a book entitled Two Prosperous Decades that the center launched last February. The book discusses the achievements of the era of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa over the past two decades. His Highness Sheikh Nasser conveyed the greetings and congratulations of His Majesty the King and praised the efforts of the Center's Chairman of the Board of Trustees, Dr. Sheikh Abdullah bin Ahmed Al Khalifa. His Highness praised the book's conclusions, which documents the achievements of His Majesty the King for future generations. His Highness said that His Majesty continues to offer a vision for the future for the sons and daughters of the kingdom, and that it is up to everyone to make the effort to realize this vision. His Highness expressed confidence in the ability and willingness to Bahrainis to realize His Majesty's vision, which he said will ultimately serve the interests of the country and its people. His Highness said the political achievements of this era have touched the lives of all Bahrainis and have translated into further development and progress. His Highness added that the modernization and development that have been taking place over the past two decades in Bahrain are the fruits of the ideas of His Majesty the King, who conceived his ideas in an urgent manner. His Highness said that His Majesty gave special thought and consideration to economic matters, which puts Bahrain on the path of rapid development and turned it into a desirable destination for investments by business persons from around the world. His Highness's talk concluded that the book will serve a reference to future generations when they reflect on the achievements of this era and attempt to understand the key role that His Majesty the King played in shaping them.
يقولون أفقد بعض المصداقية فتكلمت في أبي خاصة أو معزبي أو قائدي أو مليكي في نفس الوقت. ولكن يعني الحقيقة أنا محظوظ أني أشوف الصورة هذه وكنت أتذكرها يوم جات الملك رفع هذا الكتاب يبتسم وفرحان جدا بهذا الإنجاز الكبير. وأنا حقيقة ذاك الوقت مثلكم كنت شاب صغير ولا كنت عارف بالضبط وش معنى هذه الفرحة وش معنى هذا الكتيب الصغير الأحمر ولا كنت حتى عارف مدى أهمية هذا الكتاب، لأن حكم العمر وحكم قل الخبرة وإلى آخره. لكن ثم تشرفت لله الحمد بعد توفيق من الله أني أكون خادم لتوجيهات سيدي جلالة الملك وأن نحقق أحلامه ونجعلها على أرض الواقع. ثم بديت أفهم معنى هذا الكتاب، ثم بديت أعرف رؤية جلالة الملك، ثم أصبحت منخرط في عمق رؤية جلالة الملك أن احنا نحقق المستحيل. ولكن في نهاية الأمر أريد أن أخبركم أن هذا ما هو بجهد شخصي من جلالة الملك ولا هو بجهد منفرد. سعادة السفراء موجودين معنا اليوم يعرفون عمق بلدانهم مع هذا البلد، يعرفون عمق الأخوة والمحبة والتعاون والتاريخ مع كل حاكم وكل مسؤول في هذا البلد. فأنتوا ما يحتاج أخبركم لأن أنتوا أخبر مني في هذا العلم. وبالنسبة لي توجيهات جلالة الملك وقيادته، ترى هو ما استلهم ولا حصل هذا الاندفاع ولا حصل هذه الروح ولا حصل هذه الرؤية إلا بعد ما شاف شعبه وقوتهم وتكاتفهم وصدقهم واجتهادهم في العمل. عرف أن كل خطوة راح يخطوها راح يجد ناس شباب وشابات وذوي الخبرة جادين في هذا العمل، يريدون أن يتقدمون للأمام، يريدون أن تزدهر مملكة البحرين، ويريدون معا تحدي كل الصعاب وأنهم يعدونه. والأمثلة كثيرة، لكن أنا اليوم ما أبغي أخليكم في الماضي. إحنا بنتكلم اليوم ولله الحمد خلصنا عقدان مزهران، لكن دائما نستلهم من كلمة جلالة الملك أن الأيام الجميلة ما بعد عشناها، ما يعلم الغيب إلا الله سبحانه وتعالى. ولكن الأمثلة ولله الحمد والتجارب والنجاحات نشوفها أمامنا اليوم يوم بعد يوم، نشوف حكمة جلالة الملك معانا، ربان هذه السفينة يعدي كل الصعاب بوقفة شعبه، بوقفة ناسه، لأن اليوم جلالة الملك ما استهلهم كل هالقوة هذه إلا بعد هذه القدرة العالية منكم. فلازم أذكركم مرة ثانية، وأن الذكرى تنفع المؤمنين، ترى مو بكل من جالس على طاولة مستديرة، ومو من كل من جالس في مكتب كبير، ومو من كل من جالس في رئاسة مؤسسة أو معسكر أو شركة أو إلى آخر من هالمؤسسات الدولة هو سر النجاح. سر النجاح يكتمن في جميع الناس، في جميع الطبقات، في جميع الوظائف. كلنا اليوم مهمين، كل شخص في مملكة البحرين مهم جدا أن يوصل هذه الرسالة. أتكلم عن أكبر الأمور إلى أصغرها، وكل هذه الأعمال في مملكة البحرين مهمة جدا لجلالة الملك. تذكر دكتور أول أمس شو وجهك جلالة الملك؟ من يومين جلالة الملك يوجه الدكتور الله طول عمره بتوجيه بسيط جدا لكن له منفعة كبيرة لشبابنا وشاباتنا، أن حولوا هذه الروايات اللي أنتوا اللي خدتوها وجمعتوها، أو الحزاوي اللي إحنا نتكلم عنها والقصص التراثية، إلى شيء مشروع إعلامي يتثقفون منه شبابنا ويعيشون على هذا الشيء ويشوفونه ويعرفون الماضي. فهذا مثال بسيط جدا لكن جهد كبير منكم، والحقيقة يعني أشكركم على هذا الجهد. في أمور أخرى كبيرة نتكلم عنها، من استراتيجية، من عسكرية، من اقتصادية، من اجتماعية، من تكلموا في كل الأمور، لأن إذا بنتكلم بنعدها اليوم بكرة بيسبقنا جلالة الملك. أنا كرئيس مؤسسة الخيرية ما قط نجحت مع جلالة الملك في شيء، أروح أقترح عليه شيء يكون هو مقترح قبل، أو إذا قبل أرفع السماعة يكون هو معطيني شيء. فإحنا دائما خطوة في الخلف، وهو دائما خطوة إلى خطوتين أمامنا، وهذا ولله الحمد دليل نجاح جلالة الملك. يعني معالي السيدة فوزية هني مثال كبير جدا من نجاحات جلالة الملك ومن نجاحات مرأة مملكة البحرين. فلازم إذا بتتخلوني اليوم تعطوني الوقت والمجال أن يتكلم، أبصم لكم بالعشر أن بخليكم لأول مرة في حياتكم متواصلون يومين مستمرين بدون سكر. لكن في نهاية الأمر أنا مرة ثانية أقول لكم، أفقد المصداقية لبعض الناس اللي من الخارج كوني يعني منه أنا وقربي من جلالة الملك، لكن أنا اليوم مثل ما ذكرت لكم أنا خادم لهذه التوجيهات. كل إنسان في مملكة البحرين مهم، الأيام الجميلة قادمة بإذن الله، وراح إن شاء الله مثل ما مضى علينا عقدان مزهران إحنا إن شاء الله راح نشوف العقود المثمرة أمامنا مثل ما قلتي لأخت فوزية. فالنبت المزهر هو اللي مثمر إن شاء الله، فالأساس جعله جلالة الملك لنا يكون متين وقوي، عدينا الصعاب مع بعض، وهذا مثل ما يقال رب ضارة النافعة، إن إحنا اليوم مرينا في صعاب سوا وعرفنا التهديد وعرفنا المخاطر، وإحنا اليوم شعب واعي، وأنا كمسؤول عن الشباب أعرف أن عندنا شباب قد المسؤولية ومطموحين، وأنا طموح بهم، وكل الطاقة اللي تشوفونها مني مستلمها منهم، لأن أشوف الطاقة في عينهم وأشوف الإيجابية في عينهم وأشوف المستوى في عيونهم. فهذا اللي يخلي مهمتنا سهلة جدا، أن احنا نعطيهم هذه المواضيع، ولله الحمد يبهروننا ويشرفوننا في كل محافل العالمية. علم مملكة البحرين ولله الحمد ما رفرف عالي إلا مرة أخرى مع وقفة أخوان من الدول الشقيقة ووقفة شعب مع حاكم. فالشكر موصول لكم مرة ثانية على حضوركم معانا، أتمنى أني أكون أنا موجود وياكم طول هذه الندوة واستمع إلى أفكاركم، لكن الأخ عبد الله ما يقصر، دائما يرسل لي هالأوراق ودائما يرسل لي هالمعلومات اللي تخلونا دائما مطلعين على أعمالكم اللي فعلا يعني ملموسة. فأتمنى مرة أخرى عبد الله أنكم أنتم توصلوا لي خلاصة هذه الندوة مرة ثانية، وكلماتكم كلها محل التقدير والعرفان، وحضوركم مرة أخرى مقدرين له، واتمنى لكم ان شاء الله كل التوفيق. ونهاية يعني مفروض الكلمة هذه أبدابها، لكن سيدي جلالة الملك كلفني اني اوصل لكم تحياته وتقديره ومحبته، وقال لي الحقيقة لا تتكلم عني فيها امام الناس، لكني ما اقدر، فهذه يعني انتم بعد لا تعلمون، فالله الله يستر. لكن الحين المنصات الاعلاميه فضحتنا قدام الجميع، لكن المحبه ما حد يقدر يخفيها، سواء كان ابن ولا كان قريب ولا كان مواطن ولا كان شخص من بلد ثاني، ولله الحمد. مشكور الله طول عمرك. شكرا.
إن عقدان مزهران ليس كتاباً يروي قصة ملك، بل إنه يوثق لقصة أمة ووطن.
Dr. Sheikh Abdallah said the book documents and analyzes the reform project under the leadership of His Majesty the King, which remains a turning point in Bahraini history as it has promoted noble principles and took the country to the ranks of developed countries. He also dedicated the book to His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander, and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa.
صنعها آل خليفة ومن معهم من أبناء البحرين الطيبين صورة على هيئة العرب وإرادة لا تشبه إلا العرب. أيتها الأخوات، أيها الأخوة، علمنا التاريخ أن الحكام العدول هم الذين يلبون متطلبات الحياة بحاضرها ومستقبلها، وهؤلاء هم المؤمنون البررة الذين اصطفاهم الله سبحانه وتعالى للنهضة بأمة قال فيها الباري عز وجل: وكنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس. وهكذا كان آل خليفة، وصان رسالتهم مليكنا حمد. وكتاب اليوم الذي خلده جلالة الملك بإنجازاته، فأمرنا فأطعنا فوثقناها للأجيال القادمة كي تعرف وتدرك أي واجب ينتظرها للحفاظ على وطننا ومنجزاته. ولا بد هنا من استذكار الدور التاريخي والمميز الذي نهض به صاحب السمو الملكي الأمير خليفة بن سلمان الخليفة رئيس الوزراء الموقر، الذي حقق تطلعات وأماني جلالة الملك المفدى في ارتقاء مملكة البحرين وأدراكها الذرى وحقق النجاح. عقدان مزهران، تلكم هديتنا، نأمل أن تنال منكم المباركة والبحث، لأن الكتاب الذي ازدان قيمة ورفعة بأن كرمه ومن عليه سيدي صاحب السمو الملكي الأمير سلمان بن حمد الخليفة ولي العهد نائب القائد الأعلى النائب الأول لرئيس مجلس الوزراء بتقديمه لقرائه. وعقدان مزهران هو أول من وثق رغبة جلالة الملك في انتقال المرأة البحرينية من مرحلة كسب الحقوق إلى عدالة الشراكة.
The representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Work and Youth Affairs, President of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa praised the achievement of Bahrain in Kempton race in the UK. His Highness hailed the result and said that this achievement drives to exerting more efforts to achieve further achievements in international events. He also praised the strong competition that the race witnessed with the participation of distinguished horses from various countries. His Highness also praised the efforts of the trainer Simon Crisford and his role in fully preparing the horse for the race. He also praised the rider Andrea Trini and his successful leadership in winning the first place. His Highness hailed the role of the supervising team and their efforts in preparing the horses to win the first title. The first Deputy President of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, President of Bahrain Athletics Association, and President of Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, received today the Mixed Martial Arts National Team Coach and Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, Mixed Martial Arts Member, Eldar Adiraf, on the occasion of winning the 23rd edition of the Brave Championship in the Super Lightweight category after he took on Tunisian player Munir Lazi, which was held in Amman, Jordan. His Highness Sheikh Khalid hailed the achievement of Eldar Adiraf, which made him the first Bahraini player to win the title, which is added to the list of Bahraini achievements in the MMA sports and strengthens Bahrain's its strong presence on the global sports map. His Highness hailed Adiraf's high technical level in the championship, wishing him further success.
Alhamdulillah, it was my dream to become a world champion from the first day. I started my career, you know, from small ages, like 6 years old. I started when I was six. From that time, I was dreaming to become a world champion and training for this. And imagine how happy I am now. My dream became true. And of course, it's because of support of Sheikh Khalid. I'm very happy that I have this team, I have this support, and I'm very proud to be part of this team, KHK.
His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa today attended the closing ceremony of the 29th Bahrain Defense Force recitation of the Holy Quran, a Knowledge of Islamic Studies competition held under his patronage. Upon arrival, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed was welcomed by the BDF Assistant Chief of Staff for Human Resources, Major General Sheikh Ali bin Rashid Al Khalifa, Commander of the Bahraini Royal Special Force, Major General Isa Mohammed Al Ramehi, the Religious Guidance Director, and a number of senior BDF officials. During the ceremony, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed highlighted the support provided by the BDF in organizing the annual event, which provides a platform to provide knowledge on the noble teachings of Islam. His Highness Sheikh Mohammed congratulated the winning participants and praised the outstanding level of proficiency demonstrated during the recital and memorization of the holy verses of the Quran. The ceremony began with the recitation of the Holy Quran, followed by a speech given by Religious Guidance Director Brigadier Salim Ali Al-Bu'aynain, in which he welcomed His Highness and extended his appreciation and gratitude for his patronage of the closing ceremony. Brigadier Al-Bu'aynain also expressed thanks to the BDF General Command for organizing the ceremony and their continuous support to such activities that encourage and support Islamic teachings. Colonel Ahmed Isa Al-Busmeet then gave a speech on behalf of the participants in which he expressed appreciation for His Highness's patronage of the ceremony. He also praised the efforts of the BDF's Religious Guidance Directorate in organizing activities that promote Islamic principles and values. His Highness greeted the panel of judges and distributed certificates and awards to the winners. He also honored the Royal Bahraini Air Force as the unit with the highest level of participation. His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Salman was then presented with a commemorative gift by the BDF Assistant Chief of Staff for Human Resources.
Thank you.
The Shura Council held its weekly meeting today, presided over by its chairman, Ali bin Saleh al-Saleh, where it approved a proposal amending a number of provisions of Decree 14 of 2002 on practicing political laws. The council rejected a draft law on designating 50% of investment island beaches for public use. The council also approved a proposal on reducing the consumption of energy drinks. The Emir of Kuwait, His Highness Sheikh Sabah al-Ahmed al-Jaber al-Sabah, received today at Bayan Palace the Minister of Information Affairs, Ali bin Mohammed al-Ramehi, on the occasion of his visit to Kuwait to attend the Arab Media Forum, where he conveyed to His Highness the greetings of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa al-Khalifa, His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman al-Khalifa, His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad al-Khalifa, and their wishes of abundant health and happiness to the Kuwaiti Emir and of progress and prosperity to the Kuwaiti people. His Highness the Emir of Kuwait welcomed the Minister of Information Affairs, praising the deep and solid brotherly relations between the two countries and their progress in all fields, especially in media affairs, under the generous patronage and directives of the two leaderships in the two countries. His Highness asked the Minister to convey his greetings and appreciation to His Majesty the King and his wishes of development and prosperity to the people of Bahrain. The Minister of Information Affairs expressed thanks and appreciation for the generous hospitality and warm welcome, which reflects the brotherly ties between the two countries and peoples, wishing Kuwait, the Emir, the government and the people development and prosperity. The Bahrain Association of Banks held a press conference announcing the 100th anniversary of celebrating the Kingdom's Bahrain's banking sector, highlighting the sector's vital role in supporting the national economy in the presence of the Governor of the Central Bank of Bahrain, Rashid Al-Ma'raj. More in this report.
Bahrain celebrates the 100th anniversary of its banking sector, which plays an important role in the kingdom's sustainable economic development and promoting its leading position locally, regionally, and internationally. Bahrain hosts now 382 financial institutions with total assets of $192 billion, including 98 banks, 21 of which are Islamic banks. The banking sector strongly contributes to diversifying sources of income and creating jobs for Bahrainis, being the second highest contributor to GDP after oil by more than 16%. The banking sector achieves an annual growth of about 10%. It's one of the largest employment sectors in the Kingdom of Bahrain, with over 14,000 individuals currently employed in the field.
Very proud of this achievement. And I think if there is anything that we can say about this whole journey is the level of contribution of our Bahraini workforce. I'm proud to say that we are having now Bahraini bankers, men and women, working not only in Bahrain, but in the region and beyond the regions. And this reflects how far we have come in terms of the quality of the training, the quality of the people, and that had made them be able to work with international institutions across the globe.
The evolution of the banking sector over the years was displayed, highlighting the banking renaissance in the mid-70s with the introduction of the offshore bank experience and the transformation of Bahrain to a direction of the world's largest known banks, as well as the establishment of several large Gulf and Arab banks, which continue to take their role in the global financial and banking of the kingdom.
Crossing the 100 years of having the first bank in Bahrain. And that was started in 1920. But the first discussions took place in 1900. And it took them about 10 to 15 years to enable the authority at that time to approve having the first bank in Bahrain. At that time, it was established, it was named Eastern Bank, which is right now, we call it Standard Charter Bank. That was the first foreign bank in Bahrain. In 1950, we established the first Bahraini bank, which was National Bank of Bahrain. And then we start having all the banks in Bahrain. But the jump of banking started from 1973. And 1973, it was a booming year. Till 1980, that was most of the foreign institution, the big institution, they have a based in Bahrain, all of them, whether European, Asian, Americans, or Latin Americans. I will say that we in Bahrain are the first country in the Gulf which has a banking, and we are also among the first countries in the Arab world which we have a present of a foreign bank in Bahrain.
Hence, today's press conference promotes the idea of investing in the occasion of the 100th anniversary of establishment of banks in Bahrain to be celebrated on December 2019 in order to highlight all these great achievements. Over the past 100 years, Bahrain has recorded major success stories in the banking and financial sector, and today we highlight the role of this crucial sector to the development of national economy. Reporting for Bahrain International, Mehba Abdelghafour.